Now, this, I've been really looking forward to this part. This is the video question portion that I talked about last podcast. So okay. I said, if you guys have any questions for us, you can actually send us some videos of yourself. So you filming yourself asking us some questions. Now, we received three of those, but one of those I can't download because that person did not give me access to their Google Drive. So when I go to download it, it just says you don't have access. So Sean, I believe your name is, if you want to resend that and give me access or resend it a different way, like through Dropbox. Actually, Dropbox, oh man.
Would you stop that?
I can't help it. These mic arms suck.
You can help it because you're talking with your Italian self. You have less than 1% hey. Italian DNA.
Bada bing, bada boom.
But you seem to be, like, you just keep your hands down where they belong and you're fine.
I'm a hand talker.
Well.
I'll put them behind my back. There.
Yeah, it's not going to work. You'll probably not be able to speak.
Now I'll move my head. I got to move something. I'm a fidgeter. So if you, Dropbox would be the best option for anyone in the future who wants to send us a question. Just if you don't know what Dropbox is, it's free. You just upload your video to that. You can get a share link, and then you just share the link with me, and I can go download it. That's definitely the easiest way. But you can email your videos to us at posttopostshow@gmail.com if you have any questions. So I only have two because I couldn't get the couldn't get one. So we have two questions here.
All right.
So if you want to go ahead and open up the first one, this is from Nick, and his question is about Chicago.
Okay, here we go.
Hey, Neil and Brett. My name is Nick, and I run the YouTube channel Nick S. Blackhawks Talk. And I would like to get your guys' input on Corey Crawford finally coming back from his 10-month-long concussion. Can you see the Hawks having a true boost in momentum going into the rest of the season? I know it's early yet, but I feel like it's a possibility with having one of the best goalies being back. I feel like it can help the team in a all-around play, even though the Hawks defense is kind of weak at points. Thank you for taking my question, and most of all, let's go Hawks.
All right, so great question there from Nick, and just a quick note, the jerseys in behind him look a lot like the jerseys in behind us, so it looks like he collects jerseys, so that's great to see.
Yeah.
And he had a very good question about Crawford, so he's been back for a couple games now, I think five. Mm-hmm. His goals against average is 2.44, and his save percentage is 919. Those are pretty respectable numbers after you come back from a concussion. So I think just looking statistically at his numbers, things look pretty good. And if you look at the rest of the team, Keith and Seabrook, in my opinion, really have declined over the past 18 months. I think he mentioned that there in the video that the defense is questionable at times. So I think he made some good points there. And I agree with him that Crawford coming back does give the team a bit of a boost. Cam Ward hasn't really played that great for Chicago this year. So I definitely agree with Nick there and his question or his comments there of Crawford really giving a boost to the team.
Yeah, I would agree. And I think there are some other examples in the past where players have had a long layoff because of concussion or whatever other disabling condition they've had. And then they come back and they do really well. And one of the players that they were talking about last night in that category is Chris Letang.
Oh, yes. That's a really good example.
And he was out for a long time and it really didn't look good for him to be an effective returning player. But this year, he's outstanding.
Mm.
Maybe playing the best hockey he's ever played. So the layoff to recover from something like that can be hard and get your mind out of the game on one hand, but the amount of energy you can recover in your body to play hard when you do come back is the other side of that coin.
Yeah, absolutely. Crosby's another good example there as well. He had concussion issues, came back, and was the same Crosby he's always been. So
yeah. So nowadays that we know more about concussions, we can have much better care for players or anyone when that happens, and a lot of very intense medical follow-up and protocols, and when they do come back, they're ready to come back.
Exactly.
Now, rather than trying to come back too early because the owner wants them back in or something, right? So I'm optimistic.
I agree.
All right.
All right. Next question comes from an unnamed person. They didn't say their name, but it's about San Jose, so go ahead and play it.
All righty, here it comes.
All right, post to post, how would you rate the San Jose Sharks' current season? A, B, C, or D?
All right, San Jose Sharks, how would I rate their season? This is a tough one because I think although they are playing well, they aren't playing as well as we expected them to. Carlson coming in, some other changes and stuff. So if I had to apply a letter grade to them, I'd probably say B minus. If I can add some minuses and pluses, I'm going to say B minus.
Mm-hmm. I'd be in the B range. They're leading their division, which is good. Mm-hmm. But their division is so competitive that they're only really, I think, 2 points ahead of the second to last team or the third to last team in their division. So a couple of games can turn the tide, and they could be sitting in the bottom half of that.
Yeah,
so.
And their division's a little weird anyway, because LA's doing so poorly, and Anaheim's mm-hmm. now on this three-game losing streak as we're filming this.
And yeah, the bottom two teams in that division right now are Vegas and LA.
Yeah, and they were two of the best teams last year.
And they probably will end up being two of the better teams in the division before the season's over. So San Jose has to not that they have to do anything different, but the fans and the players, they have to be aware that even if they can point to being in first place right now, that's nowhere near where they need to be. They need to be creating distance and space between themselves and the teams that are chasing them, and right now they're not doing that.
They're lucky their surrounding teams there in the division are playing so poorly, some of them. Otherwise, they might be in the middle of the pack there.
Yeah.
So. All right. The last thing on my list here is comment highlight. This is something else I wanted to do. I mentioned last week I wanted to pick out a good comment that I see throughout the week on our channel and read it and get your thoughts on this. And you might have already seen this, and this isn't exactly what they wrote, but it's pretty much exactly what they wrote. So it came from IE Sports Network, and they said, personally, I definitely think Ovechkin can, and this was in response to our video, can Ovechkin win more trophies? Mm-hmm. Ovechkin will need to score 31 goals a year for 9 more years to pass Gretzky in goals for all-time goals.
Wow.
This is entirely possible considering he is averaging 37 goals a year now. I thought that was a really good comment.
That is. He's, what, 32 years old?
He's around there. So he plays for, it's not inconceivable that
he could be in his early 40s.
Yeah, absolutely, because he's in great shape and he's going to want to he's going to chase that record. Wants it bad.
Yeah.
So
that would be something.
It's possible.
It's a record that when it was made by Gretzky, very credible hockey people were saying never will be touched.
It's the only one I think that could be broken. No one's going to pass him in points. No one's going to pass him in assists. Mm-hmm. He has more assists than anyone else does points.
Yeah.
At all times. So like, it's not going to happen. But
you never know.
Yeah, could happen. I hope it does. And, no offense to Gretzky or Gretzky fans.
And it might help Nicholas Backstrom's numbers too.
That's true. You might get some more assists there.